Hello, someone recently sent me a message here on my YouTube channel and asked what my thoughts were about the Greek pagan practice of Kourbania. And to the best of my knowledge, I had not heard of this practice. So I looked it up, and it's basically a practice where these Greek Orthodox people sacrifice an animal like a lamb to God. And it's pagan. Other people have pointed out that it's pagan. I looked at Wikipedia. This practice has received criticism. Canon 16 of the Senate of Carthage asked the emperor to condemn it. Saint Nicodemus condemned the practice, and another bishop condemned it. But to the best of my knowledge, my limited knowledge, admittedly, this practice has not been officially condemned by a council, the Orthodox Church, or the patriarchs. And I'm wondering why. Why? So it seems to me that Orthodox people, Greeks, perhaps, you know, Greeks and Russians, I think, are often more concerned about promoting their cultures. They're actually proud of their pagan past. And we see this in practices like Kourbania. We see it in the practice of the utterly pagan and demonic two intertwined serpents on the bishop's staff. So what the Orthodox do is they realize that something that they adhere to is so thoroughly pagan and unchristian and unbiblical. And then eventually they get to the point where they're going to have to address this. So it's like they desperately look in the Bible or the Old Testament to find justification for these practices. So it's later, they later go back to the Old Testament to look for justification for this. This is what we see in the case of the two intertwined snakes on the bishop's staff. You cannot defend this practice biblically. There is a drastic ontological distinction between one snake on a staff and two snakes on a staff. This is not the same animal. This is not the same thing. And you cannot find biblical justification for this. If you look at Moses' staff in the Old Testament, God specifically requested one serpent on a pole. But what the Orthodox have done is they put two snakes on a pole. This is caduceus. If you research the pagan past of Turkey, you will see that it was a serpentine culture. I've already made videos about this. The two intertwined snakes goes back to the Aztecs. It's pagan. It's Sumerian. So the Orthodox, when they, you know, they often are proud of their pagan past, refuse to repent of their paganism, so then later go back to the Bible looking for justification. But this is not, these two serpents on the bishop's staff is not the one serpent on Moses' staff. There's an ontological distinction here. These are totally different. And by adding an additional snake, you have totally proven that this is not Moses' serpent. So the Orthodox are not going to be able to justify these two serpents. They're not going to be able to justify it biblically or theologically. This is pagan. See, Turkey and Constantinople in their pre-Christian times was thoroughly serpentine and pagan. So this is a replica of their pagan past. You cannot justify this biblically. With regard to Kourbania, of course you cannot justify this biblically, but there are Orthodox people who have done this. If you look at the Wikipedia article, an attempt is made to go to the Old Testament for this. No, you cannot do this. This is Hellenic. This is pagan Greek custom. It has absolutely nothing to do with the concepts and teachings of biblical Christianity. So what they did, I think, in my opinion, is that they realized this is so pagan, so, well, we're going to have to look to the Bible to find some justification for this. Well, it's too late. You cannot do this. This is not biblical by any stretch of the imagination. The Old Testament sacrificial system was a shadow pointing to Christ. Christ is the fulfillment of the sacrificial system. The Bible, Old and New Testaments, does not teach the concept that we are to continue animal sacrifices. This is pagan. Okay, so you're not going to be able to justify this practice biblically. So what do you people want to do? You want to keep us back? You want to be Judaizers? I mean, do you want to keep us back in the Old Testament sacrificial system? Do you recognize the one sacrifice for sin forever that Christ made on the cross? Do you recognize that? He completed this. He is the fulfillment, the substance of the Old Testament shadow, the Old Testament sacrificial system. So if you read the writings of St. Paul, for example, in his epistles, you see that Christ is the fulfillment of this system. The Bible does not teach, nor did the early Christians teach, that we are to continue sacrificing animals to God. This is thoroughly pagan, and it is absolutely not justified from a biblical standpoint. So you people need to repent of your paganism. It's like, have a little biblical Christianity with your paganism. Some of you Greek Orthodox people love paganism so much, I don't even know what you're doing in the field of Christianity at all. You need to repent of this paganism. You need to totally destroy Caduceus, the two intertwined snakes on the bishop's staff. You need to utterly destroy this Kourbania. These are pagan practices, but I think Greeks are actually proud of their pagan past. And that's why I have not seen an Orthodox patriarch condemn Caduceus. I have not seen a Orthodox emperor condemn Kourbania. So they're actually proud of their pagan past. And the Greeks and the Orthodox can be nationalistic. And culture is very important to some of these Greek Orthodox people. They're more concerned about culture and promoting their cultures than they are in promoting the transcultural gospel of Jesus Christ. And you people need to repent of your paganism. There's no biblical or theological justification for these pagan practices, and I thank you for your time. I want to go ahead and add something else here. I need to emphasize that in the Old Testament, the animal sacrificial system was specifically given by God to the Jews. This was never intended to be a practice among pagans and Greeks. Okay, so you need to keep that in mind. God specifically gave this instruction to the Jewish people. It was a shadow of Christ. It was all pointing to Christ, the ultimate sacrificial Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This has been fulfilled. So by duplicating this Old Testament sacrificial system, you're basically saying in essence that you don't recognize the sacrifice of the Lamb of God. You don't recognize Christ as the substance, the fulfillment of this Old Testament system. So this practice, Kourbania, is problematic from a biblical and theological standpoint, and I thank you for your time.